Welcome back, Earl Butch Graves Jr.
Ladies, okay, ladies, I know you're all excited, but I need you to please take a seat. Thank you, ladies. Now, has everyone enjoyed themselves all the way through to where we are today? And how many of you are just coming in from the ladies' night out? I wanted to take a moment, which is very important to me, to thank some people here who've made this possible. And while I get an opportunity to stand in front of you oftentimes and speak to the group, and we have dynamic speakers who come and honorees that we go through, this event could not happen without a great staff that I have here at Black Enterprise. And so while there is 1,800 of you, we have 40 people from Black Enterprise that helped to put this on, and I want to recognize them. Now, I'm not going to list all 40 people, so you can be calm. You don't have to worry about that. But each department, the events department, we have an events department that is second to none. They put on the best events everywhere, all the time. And the reason it runs so smoothly, the reason it's done, and I'm on them, trust me, harder than anyone is. But they do a job that is second to none. So I'd like our event staff, wherever you may be, please stand and be recognized. Hard to see who's standing and who's not. But anyway, okay. They're here. Our content team that creates this programming, that invites these speakers, that meticulously goes through analyzing who the right people are and putting that all together and selecting who our honorees and luminaries are. So I want to congratulate and thank our content team for the job that you do. Our sales team, they would tell me they're second to none, and they are. And they do a tremendous job, not just in selling this and getting our sponsors involved, but actually integrating, vertically integrating, horizontally integrating our clients into this program that makes this event so great. So thank you to our sales team, and let's give them a round of applause as well. Now, I'm not going to take you through each of the other ones individually that way, but I want to let you understand. We have a great video production team that puts on this event. They've done a tremendous job. We have a great digital team that allows for all of these things that are digitally happening, the downloading of the app, being able to know exactly where to be at all times. We have an accounting team that helps to put this together. Yes, Angelique wants to stand up. Angelique, stand up by yourself. Go ahead. Okay. She's been wanting to do that for the better part of 18 years. And we have a great HR team that makes this possible, right, to bring back the best employees and the best staff I had. So I say to them all, bless you, especially on Good Friday. God bless you, and thank you all for my staff for what you guys do. Now, I also would be remiss if I didn't introduce to you, because yes, this is the Black Enterprise family, but everyone knows that the Black Enterprise family is also the Graves family. And I'm blessed to have my family here to be a part of this. I had my parents years ago who helped me, or helped us to get this started. And we now continue to this day into the next generation. So I want to introduce the members of the Graves family that have come here today. I'm going to start with my niece, Melanie Graves. You stand up. And for Bank of America, she's sitting at that table. She works at Bank of America, so if you haven't seen her, Okay. My niece, Veronica Graves. Beautiful Veronica Graves, if you would stand. Caroline Graves. Now, I want to say it for a moment. Caroline Clark Graves. I'm going to use it right. I'm going to get it right. But I want her to stand because without Caroline, frankly, following in the footsteps of my mother, this event would not become the event it has become. So, Caroline, please stand and be recognized. My very handsome brother, Johnny Graves, who would tell you he's very handsome himself. Johnny, try to stand. He's getting his hip replaced. Who's here? And then my nuclear family that is here. You're about to meet one of them. But I have twin daughters, Erica Graves, if Erica would stand. Her brother, Earl Graves III, we call him Gibby, if he would stand. Theodore Graves, we call him Teddy, or T.O. And of course, the boss, my wife, Roberta Graves, she would stand. Okay, I want to that's all the family members. No more family members to introduce. Well, there's one, but you're going to see her in a minute. And that's my daughter, Kristen. Yes, I got this. Thank you, Angelique, for your input. Before I get to thank all of our sponsors and the UnitedHealth Group, well, let me start with them. The UnitedHealth Group, I want to thank you. So, let's give a round of applause to UnitedHealth Group, the sponsor of today's Luminary Luncheon, for what they've done. And lastly, I want to thank, and this person, she is my, if you will, work, the person I work closest to or closest with, does a tremendous job for me, does a tremendous job for Black Enterprise, and I want to recognize Yolanda Cook, who's my chief of staff, for everything that she does. Yolanda, she is standing, believe it or not, she's standing. Okay, thank you all very much. You're gonna love this Luminaries Luncheon. I appreciate you, I'll get back to you at the end of the day. Congratulations to all the Luminary honorees and to all of you for making this event our largest and most successful event ever. Thank you all very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Director of Social Media and Marketing at Black Enterprise, Kristen Graves, and Content Producer at Black Enterprise, Jeroslyn JoVonn.
Good afternoon, ladies. How's everybody feeling? Kristen, do you remember last year when we kicked off the Luminary Awards and we did the wobble?
I think so.
Yes. So the only thing is, like, that's all I've been doing these days. So I want to do something a little different in honor of Beyonce's album. How about a little square dance, ladies, just to loosen us up? Just to loosen us up. Let's just do a little, get it going.
This ain't Texas.
Reel it in, Jeroslyn. We clearly don't know how to dance to country music yet, but we're all gonna learn. So I am so pleased to share this event with you. This afternoon's Luminary Awards luncheon culminates our main stage events, and what better way to close this portion of the Women of Power Summit than to recognize women who are true representatives of our summit's theme. Unveiling excellence, reflect, rise, act.
Our luminaries, powerful rising stars in their respective fields, are lighting up their industries with innovation, disruption, out-of-the-box thinking, and visions of creating a better world than the one they inherited. And not only are they looking ahead, but they're also taking a look back to challenge old notions, making us all sit up and take notice, keeping our minds open for new interpretations and possibilities of what could or should lie ahead. Each award is being presented by a sponsor representative, all women of power in their own right. So thank you, FINRA, Dell, and UnitedHealth Group, for believing and investing in these amazing young leaders. And here to start us off with the first presentation is the Vice President of Talent Acquisition and Chief Diversity Officer for FINRA. Please welcome Audria Pendergrass Lee.
Thank you, Jeroslyn, and greetings, sisters. It is my privilege to present this afternoon's first award to engineering powerhouse, Aisha Bowe. True to the eponymous award that we are about to bestow upon her, this shining star's ultra-impressive resume literally gleams. Her company, STEMBoard, is a multi-million dollar technology business that uses its profits to bring minorities into science and technology. It has been recognized not once but twice as one of the fastest growing companies in America. Her passion to empower young people to pursue careers in the sciences led her to create yet another company, LINGO, a self-paced coding kit for learning technical concepts at home. With her product both sold and championed by such retail giants as Walmart and Amazon, Aisha's vision can continue to penetrate the fabric of education innovation. And perhaps the crowning jewel in Aisha's constellation of achievements is her impending journey beyond the confines of our earthly realm. This former NASA rocket scientist and soon to be astronaut Aisha stands poised to etch her name in the annals of history as the first African-American woman to traverse the cosmos aboard a vessel crafted by the Jeff Bezos-founded Blue Origin Aerospace Company. Here's more.
She's a science superstar headed for the stars. Aisha Bowe is a former NASA engineer scheduled to be the first African-American to rocket into space with the Blue Origin team of Amazon's Jeff Bezos. Her journey to space began with her father's advice to take math classes at the local community college. From there, she soared, earning her master's in space systems engineering, determined to become the black role model missing at the nation's space agency. Her achievements at NASA were recognized with the agency's Equal Opportunity Employment Medal and boosted her exposure through the State Department's U.S. Speakers Program. After NASA, she launched her own business, founding and chairing STEMBoard, to empower students to pursue careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. Then, after fundraising millions, she created LINGO, an at-home coding kit. She was also recognized as a 2023 honoree of Black Enterprise's 40 Under 40 list. She has also endowed an engineering scholarship that starts at her community alma mater, Washtenaw Community College, and ends with a degree from her graduate alma mater, the University of Michigan. For her efforts to make science both grounded and out of this world, the space she has created for creative minds, and for the educational opportunities she has made possible for so many, Black Enterprise is proud to present the 2024 Women of Power Luminary Award to Aisha Bowe. Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. You need me
We not only celebrate Aisha's individual triumphs, but also pay homage to the enduring spirit of innovation and determination that defines the human experience. Aisha, may your journey continue to inspire generations to reach for the stars, transcend barriers, and ignite the flames of possibility. It is my honor to present the 2024 Black Enterprise Women of Power Luminary Award to Aisha Bowe.
When I started my first business, I still remember the look my mother gave me when I told her I was going to leave my government job and found a startup. Let's just say she was not a fan. Unfortunately, this reaction to unconventional paths to success is not uncommon. Last week, a woman approached me about a costume for her four-year-old daughter. Her daughter wanted a NASA spacesuit. She expressed hesitation in buying the suit because she initially felt it was unlikely for her daughter to become an astronaut. She didn't want to encourage what she thought might have been an unattainable dream. How ironic it was that she was saying it to me, someone on the road to space. You see, I am here to disrupt. I am here to challenge the narratives that have far too long limited what we, as Black women, are expected or allowed to accomplish. Despite the initial lack of support, I chose to follow my dreams, and now my mother is Employee of the Month every month at LINGO, where she hand-packs. Where she hand-packs each and every kit that's delivered to a home. Today, I want to ask you to help me create more luminaries. I stand here on the shoulders of countless women who have blazed trail, six of whom have been into space. A number I think is far too small. I'm pretty sure a Black woman should be the future president of the galaxy. Don't you agree? Luminaries are not born. They are made when a spark of potential is fanned by the winds of courage, innovation, and action. There are luminaries in this room who have not yet realized their power. They will be empowered by you, your stories, and your courage. Through my story, that mother who thought she was only buying her daughter an astronaut costume realized that she was actually helping her realize that her dreams are now within reach. Thank you. Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me, no matter where you go.
Congratulations, Aisha, and thank you, Audria. Please join me in welcoming our next presenter, Diversity Senior Analyst for Dell, Mir Tillman.
Thank you, Kristen, and good afternoon. Through her unparalleled marketing magic, our next Luminary Award honoree, Dia Sims, has propelled herself to the forefront of the spirits industry. As the executive chairwoman of the board of Lobos, 1707 Tequila and Mezcal, an award-winning independent spirits brand that launched nearly 4 years ago in November 2020, she's brought an impressive track record of building successful brands, including the transformation of Ciroc Ultra Premium vodka from infancy to multi-billion dollar value brands. Dia has masterfully guided numerous brands to unprecedented levels of success, helping them grow exponentially and achieve remarkable milestones. Let's learn more.
Chief executive, entrepreneur, brand builder.
DSMs is all that and more. She presides over the award-winning Wolves of Lobos 1707 Tequila and Mezcal. The independent spirits manufacturer celebrates the spirit of the pack, and Sims does the same in both her professional and personal life. A proud HBCU alumna, she's had the backing of celebrities like LeBron James, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and Lindsey Vonn. And she started as executive assistant, then rising to president of Combs Enterprises while adding her creative vision to billion-dollar brands. She is the co-founder and current chairwoman of the Pronghorn Initiative, a 10-year program for diversity, equity, and inclusion in the spirits industry to cultivate executives, entrepreneurs, and employees of color. The goal is $2 billion in economic value through investment, incubation, and recruitment. For her vision of inclusion and economic improvement, the boldness and brashness of her brands, and her strength and spirit to open doors of opportunity, Black Enterprise is proud to present the 2024 Women of Power Luminary Award to Dia Sims.
Dia's exceptional talents and visionary leadership are nothing less than inspirational. It is my pleasure to present the Black Enterprise 2024 Women of Power Luminary Award to Dia Sims.
Thank you so very much for this incredible honor with this gorgeous room, by the way. I just want to say thank you so much to Black Enterprise, which way before it was trendy, which for another day we'll talk about what's happening, but understood the power of Black wealth to fuel Black dreams. We are all fans of what Black Enterprise stands for as an entity. But beyond an entity, I'm hopeful that we leave this incredible conference with it as a manifesto, right? And the way we think about how we change the enterprises in which we occupy, and the way that our behavior is in fact enterprising, and then the opportunity for us to own our own enterprises as being the true unlock, right, to the evolution of what the Black dream looks like in America. Beyond thrilled to get this prestigious recognition in the company of such a room filled with luminaries, and this was said last week, but something I take with me every day, one candle can light 100 candles, and it does not dim its light, right? So in the midst of a room that shines so brightly that the glow is actually internal and external with your beautiful dresses, but your personality shining through in an amazing way, the spirit of what it means to be a luminary is much more than me or any of the individual incredible honorees today, but it's so reflected in the light that reverberates from each and every one of you. Thank you.
Congratulations, Dia, and thank you, Mir. Our final award of the afternoon will be presented by our host for today's program and beautiful luncheon. Please join me in welcoming the Executive Vice President and Chief Sustainability Officer for UnitedHealth Group, Patricia L. Lewis.
Oh, those are my peeps out there. Thank you. Thank you, Jeroslyn, and thank you, everyone, for joining us this afternoon. I am so excited to be back in this space surrounded by so many beautiful, dynamic, talented, and visionary Black women. This conference continues to be one of the highlights of my year. I've been attending this event for many years, and I walk away each and every year incredibly inspired. And I'm especially excited to present the final award to such a dynamic woman. Symone Sanders Townsend is a media powerhouse. Recognized for her unapologetic frankness and fearless approach to speaking truth to power. Her journey from national Democratic strategist to White House advisor, and now as a national anchor and analyst on MSNBC's The Weekend, showcases her depth of experience and her expertise in the political arena. And in her role with MSNBC, she consistently provides reliable information and offers pointed perspectives, making her a trusted voice for viewers seeking insightful political analysis. Let's learn more.
She's a familiar face on the campaign trail and on the small screen. Symone Sanders Townsend burst onto the national political and media scene as press secretary for presidential candidate Bernie Sanders. At 25, it made her the youngest press secretary in a presidential contest and a must-have as a political commentator. That exposure would vault her into a TV analyst chair and the anchor position on her own television program. Sanders Townsend was also a senior advisor for President Biden's last campaign. She served in his administration as deputy assistant to the president and chief spokesperson for the vice president, the first Black woman in that communication position. A best-selling author, she chaired the Coalition of Juvenile Justice Emerging Leaders Committee and has been a resident fellow of both Harvard's Kennedy School and the University of Southern California's Center for the Political Future. For her ability to make her voice heard, for her advocacy on juvenile justice and justice for all, and her passion for problem solving and speaking truth to power, Black Enterprise is proud to present the 2024 Women of Power Luminary Award to Symone Sanders Townsend.
We honor this forthright woman who daily fights for information transparency, who is making sure we're all in the know as we work through the complexities of our world. It's a privilege and a pleasure to present the Black Enterprise 2024 Women of Power Luminary Award to Symone Sanders Townsend. Oh my goodness, thank you. I saw y'all dancing out there. I wanna say thank you so much to Black Enterprise for such an honor. When Butch called to say, we wanna give you this award, I was like, me? Y'all sure? This one? Because I've been here before and I had the honor of being in conversation with the incomparable Valerie Jarrett, who you all will hear from later on in this program. But yes, we can clap for Valerie Jarrett, we must, okay? So this is a full circle moment for me, and to be in the room, as Dia said, with so many luminaries. What's the word better than luminary? What's brighter than a luminary? Because that's what this is. To be in a room such as this, to receive this honor today with my husband, Sean, here, and my mother, Terry Sanders, is just truly, truly an honor. And so I know you will hear more from me later, but I wanted to share a story. In D.C., you could imagine the list of political girlies is short. Black political girlies particularly is short, but we are strong but mighty. And so we have this email listserv that we are all on, Black Girl Communications, and we send notes over our email listserv. Sometimes people send jobs. Sometimes people just send encouragement. Sometimes people send complaints. And I'm like, y'all gotta stop replying all.
But during the confirmation hearing of now Supreme Court Justice Ketanji Brown Jackson, we could clap for that. During the confirmation hearings that were broadcasted on television, so we all watched, it was particularly harrowing. I know every single black woman in this room felt what Justice Jackson felt sitting in that seat. The look on her face was a look we had all had. And our political communications listserv that day, one of the sisters on the listserv sent this note that I want to share with you all right now. And the note started like this. In 1772, Phyllis Wheatley, the first black woman to publish literature in the United States, she set trial for days while white male politicians and intellectuals, nearly all of whom were Harvard graduates and slave owners, they grilled her about the merits of her work. They tested her to see if she knew the words that were written in the book, to see if she had actually written them, if she knew enough English to have actually authored the poems. She was asked to prove, to come up with evidence that she was in fact the author of the book, as there was significant doubt from these white male readers who wanted to prove that an enslaved black woman could not write as she had written. It wasn't until after this trial that Phyllis Wheatley's work was published and she was in fact freed. My sister on the listserv goes on to say that a mentor years ago, while she was in the first year of her MFA program, where she was the youngest student and the only black student in the entire school, which is not her discipline, a mentor told her this story as she complained about what she wrote as was the unbearable whiteness of her school and of her peers. The mentor told her that this was just the beginning. He said that for the rest of her life, she would forever be on trial. That no matter how great she wrote or how good she was or how significant her ability was, there would always be someone, probably a white man, who would challenge her, who would seek to undermine her and steal from her. And he looked at her and he issued her a challenge and said, "Now what?" I issued this room the challenge of now what? The isms, as we all know, are not going away tomorrow. We have to fight them, fight against them, we have to work to combat them, but we also have to navigate through them. And I think particularly in this day and age, that challenge is more important now than ever. Thank you so much, and I look forward to talking with y'all again soon. Thank you.
Congratulations, Symone, and thank you, Patricia. Symone will be returning shortly as our featured guest for Conversations That Count, moderated by another political powerhouse, Valerie Jarrett, and hosted by today's sponsor, UnitedHealth Group. But right now, we will break to enjoy lunch, and I invite this morning's dynamic devotion speaker to come at this time and provide our invocation. Please welcome back Nona Jones.
Well, good evening this morning. If you're from the old black church, you know that's how the mother would get up there and greet everybody. I'm going to bless our food. Before I do that, if you did order my book this morning, I'm actually going to be in the sponsor lounge from 3 to 4, and I would love to see you there, all right? Let us pray. We are so grateful for this gathering, for the power that is in the room, and my prayer right now is that this meal will restore, renew, and replenish us for the work ahead of us. Bless the hands that have prepared it, and bless the fellowship that will take place as we enjoy it. In your name we pray, amen. Enjoy. Amen.